Hey y'all, Surfing Sapo here. How you doing today? Hope everybody's doing well. Anyway, today's feature, we're gonna make some Angus short ribs from Pena's Meat Market. They're custom cut, they're very thick, and we're gonna cook them out back in the Sapo Barbecue Corral on the PK grill with some B&B post oak and some lump charcoal. And we're gonna use Chupacabra, the brisket rub on these, and we'll see how they come out. So without further ado, let's get started. Well, here we have the beautiful short ribs. Let's just take a look at them, or one at least. That's how thick it is. Very nice cut of beef. Angus, got it at Pena's Meat Market. And it came from South Texas Beef. So we have two of them here. We could take the membrane off, but I'm not going to. I'm not going to worry about it. So with that being said, we'll go ahead and use this. I've been really using this a lot lately. Chupacabra Brisket Magic. It's really good. I got it at QC Meat Market over there on Port, Corpus Christi. $14.99 for this big tub, 25 ounces. So let's just get after it. And you can put it on pretty thick. It's delicious. That, flip it. And we can also add more while we're out there. We'll be smoking these on the PK grill today with mesquite lump and post oak chunks for the smoke. All right, it's good enough for now. So we'll go get the PK grill up to par and let this just get to know each other, and we'll put them on there. Okay, y'all, here we go. We got it all set up. We got our lump over here. We got our two beautiful pieces of meat right here. We're simply gonna put them on here. Maybe start off like that. I don't know. I got a probe. I got the ink bird. We'll take the ink bird probe and just simply put it inside of one of these. I guess this one. About right there. Should be good. Got it running through the vent, the wire. So we'll see how it goes. And like I said, I got these small chunks of post oak. We're just gonna simply put one in here, lay it up there on the coals. It's offset, all the heat's over here, the vent on the bottom's open on that side, and the vent on the top's open on this side. So let's see how the smoke, which direction the smoke goes. It should go out and up and away. So set it and hopefully not forget it. I got the ink bird going here. The meat's at 55, the chamber's at 140, it's raising. So we'll check this every, let's say, hour, maybe hour and a half. And we'll go by that, because the more you open it, the more it's not gonna cook. So that's how we see it. It's gonna be good, I guarantee. Okay, it's been about an hour. Let's take a look. Might have to add another chunk of wood. Oh, those are looking mighty fine, folks. Mighty, mighty fine. Look at that. Beautiful color. Let's just turn it around like that. Turn this guy around. Pull this out for a second. Put it in that one for now. Just turn this one around. And let's put us another chunk of wood, shall we? The PK grill is holding the heat in and the smoke like nothing else. Right now we're at 151 internal. So it's coming along quite well. We have one more chunk of post oak. This kind of cooking is amazing. This PK grill, I can't say enough about it. Just like a cast aluminum cooker, you know, and once you get it hot and get all these vents set correctly, this thing will keep going and going and going, and the coals last quite a long time. So that being said, we'll be back and we'll check it again. Might be the end by the next time we come back, because it's at 150. We'll probably pull it around 200. All right. Okay, we've got it to 195 internal, so it's about done. Plus, as you can see, these bones are sticking out. See that? Sticking out. So we'll take them off, put them in this pan, and we'll let them rest. And then we shall test it out. But it took, let's see, what time is it? It's about 6 o'clock. It took six and a half hours, below 300 degrees Fahrenheit. What can I say? Here they are. All right, flies found them. So let's let them rest and we'll try it out. Well, here they are, all rested up. Let me see if I can do this without blocking your view. I'm just gonna hold it like this. Use this knife here and simply cut through. Hold on. Well, need to angle it a little bit. And this one, yeah, there's a bone right there. Okay, well, we got this piece on here. See what we have. Whoop. Comes a papa. Got nice and dark on the outside. Not too much of a smoke ring because it was post oak, remember. If it was mesquite, it would be very, very dark. But actually, when you cut it, sometimes the ring shows up later. That's okay. That's not really what we're going for. We're going for doneness and flavor. So it looks like we have a success with flavor and doneness. With that being said, let's go test it out. Okay, y'all. Here we have it. Nice little short rib chunk. Rested, cut, ready to taste. Like I haven't already, right? Well, here goes nothing. Yum. Flies. That is absolutely, utterly delicious. Crunchy bark. Little smoke ring with the post oak. The chupacabra. Look at that, man. The chupacabra brisket rub. And then the rest is history. Just bite into it. It's so tender. It's like a steak, like a ribeye. And the bones, they probably pull out, but no, it's perfect. I left the membrane on, remember? So you can just pull that piece right there. Look. See how that tastes. Oh my God. Not even funny, folks. Oh my God. That is delicious. They weren't cheap. They were actually $8.99 a pound. They're Angus. And I just bought them. I was like, heck with it. I saw them in the cooler there, and I just said, hey, I want those right there. So anyway, it's a special treat, you know. But that's a good way to do it, like that, just slow, under 300 degrees, offset. Take your time, don't get in a rush. They'll come out phenomenal like this. Look at that. Absolutely amazing. So, thanks for watching. And subscribe, comment, like, all of the above, none of the above, whatever you want to do. It's up to you. But I appreciate it. And until next time, God bless you, and adios, amigos.